I'm here at Outlaws Boxing talking to boxing trainer and strength and conditioning expert Brandon Krause. And today, Coach, what are you going to teach us to show us?
Well, I got some ballistic exercises with this 12-pound med ball, bouncing med ball that I'm going to do. And we're going to do it with some exercises that are going to help us improve our punching power, improve our punching explosiveness, improve all the muscle groupings that are going to go into the technique of throwing a shot. So basically, the first thing that I want to do is get this ball in my right hand, and I'm going to be in my boxing stance. There you go. I'm going to step in and throw this med ball as hard as I can at the wall, but the way that I'm going to throw it isn't going to be like a baseball player or something like that. I'm going to throw it like I'm throwing a punch. I'm going to have this on the end of my fist, and I'm going to go through the technique of throwing a right hand, throwing the ball out, putting a little resistance behind that technique to hopefully improve the performance down the line. Yeah. 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 So what I'm doing is, by adding the resistance to the end of this movement of the right hand, will I call upon more muscle fibers to take part in this exercise, making it a more explosive movement, making it a more powerful movement, getting more bang for my buck, right? So when I'm doing it just shadow boxing, I'm teaching my nervous system to call upon X amount of muscle fibers to perform this with no resistance in my hands, right? But once I pick up this big heavy ball, now my body, to perform the same type of speed, to perform the same type of technique, is gonna have to call upon much more muscle fiber. The signal from my brain to the muscle groups is gonna have to be much stronger and more intense. And what does this do for me as an athlete? Well, this strengthens that movement. How does it strengthen that movement? Well, not in the sense of weightlifting in which your muscle fibers are torn apart and they regenerate a little bit bigger, a little bit stronger. I'm strengthening this movement neurologically by teaching my body to fire faster and to call upon more muscle fibers to do the same exact movement now with resistance on the end. So again, I'm trying my best to work through the technique of throwing a straight right hand, a lead right, all right, I'm stepping in, I have balance, I'm trying to keep my left hand up, I'm trying to make it as applicable to the ring as possible, and all I'm doing is throwing this implement, this big heavy ball, at the wall to help me produce that resistance enough to get that neurological change. Yeah. 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 And now if I want to go and throw a couple shots without it, hey, just like that big league hitter who you see warming up with five bats or that heavy donut on the end of his bat, now I don't have that resistance and I'm calling upon those muscle fibers like I do, and I can even feel my body primed up to produce more power.
Quick question, that was your right hand, that's great. What about your left hand? How would you do it with the left, from the stance of like throwing a jab? Because your right, the way you were standing, is that possible to do?
It definitely is possible. It's gonna require you to be a little bit inventive, all right? But just how I was putting that resistance on the end of my right hand and going through the technique, well, I can put this on the end of my left hand and go through the technique of my jab. Well, it's not gonna be as explosive when it hits the wall just because I'm not capable of generating as much power, but in the same vein, the power that I use to throw the jab will be improved by adding this resistance. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. My last question.
Hey, why not left hook? Yeah. Why not any punch that you can come up with? Why
uppercut?
Not any way? Uppercut, why not?
Let me see an uppercut.
Well, I don't want to hit the ceiling, but okay, you definitely, if you had a partner, you could come from underneath.
Is that what you do? That. Coach, do you have your fighters pass the ball to each other like that?
Yeah, we do. I have them go up in the ring with the not hard ball, with the soft ball, and they'll throw it to each other. in that technique of throwing punches. They'll come in here and work the ballistic exercises against the wall where you get the ricochet, and they can link these together in big rep ranges. Maybe I'll have them go 100 right hands, 100 jabs, okay? Something like that when they're in the ring with each other. Maybe I'll have them do it for a duration of time. 1 round, 2 rounds, 3 rounds. And then, look, the thing is, you want to remember that you're trying to improve your boxing, right? You want to have that overarching theme to all your strength and conditioning, that this goes for the course of improving my sport, right? You don't want to start falling in the line of many of these fitness and health crazes in which that becomes the sport, all right? So when I do this exercise, I don't care about stimulating my pec muscle and then firing my deltoid and producing the same amount of movement on this side so I don't have a muscular... No, I want my punching technique to improve. I want my right hand to get harder. So that's the only motivation I have for performing these type of exercises. And so leave out any type of vanity is what I'm trying to say.
Coach, you're an expert in your field, but I have to ask you this. I'm going to start doing this drill when I go to the gym, right? Two questions.
Yeah.
At what point does my brain realize, like, I have more power? What point do I start seeing improvement? And if I stop doing it, do I lose it?
Those are pretty deep questions, Elie. I think for every athlete, that specific point in which your brain goes, all right, we're going to call upon more muscle fibers is different, all right? Everybody's rep range, everybody's load would be different as far as their resistance goes. And, you know, in kind of a roundabout answer to your question, I would say, understand yourself as an athlete, understand where you're making gains, where you're not doing, where things are staying stagnant, all right? Understand the things that you're doing that help your performance improve, and discard the things that you feel like are a detriment to you or that may even be injuring you.
And your gym, you're cool about throwing stuff against the wall. How about, what can you do? Can you do this at your house? Can you do this
You can go to the park and you could throw it down the way 20 feet and then run up and get it, add a little bit of cardiovascular effort to it. Like I said, you can be with a partner and throw that ball to each other. These ballistic movements, meaning, you know, where you throw an object, are great because it is a coordinated movement to produce power, the same exact thing as punching, all right? And there's no coincidence that they say throw your punches.
There you have it. Thanks so much for the explanation. Stay tuned right here. Brandon Krause, EsNewsReporting.com. In Outlaws, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.